I want to question Barnum. Well, I'd like to ask Inquisitor Barnum.
What? Me? Why the hell do you want to ask me a question?
Do you have any idea who I should question?
Why are you asking me?
I knew he'd get mad. I knew I'd get a stupid answer.
If it's about the incident, then it would make sense to ask one of the witnesses. Do you not think? Do you not think?
He may have yelled at you, but at least he answered your question, Mr. Wright. Yeah, Mr. Wright. You know, maybe there's a human heart beating under all that armor after all.
Stupid question. A witness, huh? Who should I ask? Your Honor, please let me just ask one more question. One more. One more.
I hope this time you will think about what you say before opening your mouth.
Okay. Mister, can I ask you something? Is he gonna not be paying attention?
Oh, wow, he's paying attention, wow. Yeah, don't give me that scary look, Bluey. I know nothing, nothing at all. I've got nothing to tell.
Amir's as innocent as a little lamb, but is his confidence more than a sham?
Why is he still even there? He'd be better off without that bard.
You drank the tomato juice that was at the crime scene, right?
Don't keep asking me about that over and over again! So what if I did?
Then, I have another question for you. Did anything else disappear from the crime scene that day?
Nah, I didn't notice not anything. Objection. Witness, just what have you done this time? You look like a dog caught making a mess on the carpet. Why you, looking at me like that? I don't know anything about anything going missing. I'm innocent, please believe me.
Truth could drown in his swimming eyes. Some tell lies, while others cannot tell lies.
Looks like my gut feeling was right. He took something from the crime scene.
Again!
Something that could be directly connected to that red liquid around Belduk's mouth.
What on earth did that man steal from the crime scene now?
A certain item disappeared from the crime scene that day. And at this very moment, it's highly likely that item is right in front of our very eyes.
What? It's here?
Isn't that right, mister?
Is it? I have no idea. Defender, I order you to show us what this item is. The item that this witness took from the crime scene.
Got
it. It's this bottle.
The bottle?
Miss Grayer, I'd like you to clarify something for me.
What would it be, Mr. Wright?
Sir Belduke was working on creating certain medicines. He had various dangerous substances in his possession as well. How were they stored?
Master kept them in a locked medicine cabinet. The bottles were labeled so that it was clear that they were dangerous.
Clear to everyone but a certain stupid drunk.
They have all been confiscated.
As for those labels, did they resemble the label on this guy's bottle?
Mister? What are you doing with the product of Master's research?
It's not what you think! No! I didn't have any evil intentions or nothing!
That bottle belonged to the Master, and it was used to store strong poison. Poison strong enough to kill.
Poison? What?
The red liquid trickling down Sir Belduke's mouth was definitely blood. Now, as for what caused him to bleed like that from his mouth, it was deadly poison from the bottle this guy stole from the crime scene!
This is outrageous! What?
Or something, that went too fast that I pressed A accidentally.
Order! 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 Whoa, 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 whoa! Do you expect me to keep quiet? It was poison? Poison? Am I gonna die?
If you were going to die, I think you would have already have died.
Objection!
Just wait us and see. Time will tell. Yeah, I guess. More importantly, I want to know why you have that bottle! Huh? Well, that's, remember how I told you I drank the alchemist's tomato juice? Indeed, it's not something easy to forget, especially having heard it several times now. Well, that was when I saw it on the floor. This bottle right here. It was totally empty, and I thought, you know, it's such a fancy looking bottle and all.
Really?
I'm a bit of a skull fancier. They have this air of danger about them, right?
They certainly do! So,
since it was there, and I was there too, I felt we were kinda meant for each other.
What?
I thought this bottle, so classy, I could die for it!
Do you mean that in a word sense or a literal sense?
Had any poison been left in the bottle, you would have died instantly. But if it was empty, it was probably harmless.
Oh! Hear that? I'm gonna live! Good thing I rinsed it well before use!
She has her. Oh my god.
But if the victim was killed by poison, that raises a new question, of course. Who could have poisoned him?
Considering all the evidence and the testimonies we've heard today, the answer is so close. I can taste it. Sir Belduke was poisoned by... Yes, he was... He was poisoned by Amir. Actually, you know what? Aw, I can't save in this version of the game. Oh well. I was gonna say Amir because I'm pretty sure people would wonder what the hell It was, of course, Sir Belduke himself.
Sir Belduke himself?
Sir Belduke took that poison of his own free will.
His death was suicide.
Objection!
That is preposterous! A suicide? Inconceivable!
Objection!
Think about it, Inquisitor. That would explain the most unnatural aspect of his death.
The most unnatural aspect?
Miss Grey Earl, when you were strangling Sir Belduke, he put up no fight whatsoever. Is that correct?
Yes, it is. Until today, I was convinced it was due to the sleep medicine.
It wasn't, because he didn't even drink any.
The truth is, when you gripped his throat, Sir Belduke was already dead. He had poisoned himself.
Ugh.
But would the poison have caused him to bleed from his mouth?
I personally know of no poison that works instantly and causes such symptoms.
Oh, you don't?
I can't just tell them that it happens on TV all the time.
Because that is pretty much what happens, but you can't really prove that fact to old time people from medieval times.
There are certain plants in this area that contain a highly poisonous substance. In the course of his research, Master Belduke found a way to extract that poison.
What am I hearing? Is there really such a dangerous plant in Labyrinthia?
The poison is very bitter to taste, so it would be impossible to secretly slip it into someone's food or drink. It would cause internal damage. It is a very powerful poison. Drinking it would induce a most painful death.
Oh. Man.
And to think, Sir Belduke could...
But, did Sir Belduke really choose such an agonizing death for himself? It doesn't seem like he suffered that much.
I would like to know that too.
Miss Grey Earl.
You mean to say, Master killed himself after exposing me as a witch? I cannot believe it. He just wouldn't commit suicide.
Indeed, we cannot take such a theory at face value. Had he committed suicide, I dare say he would have left a suicide note.
Oh, wow.
I can't say why Sir Belduke committed suicide, but I think there's a piece of evidence that can confirm his suicide was a possibility.
There is a piece of evidence like that?
If you have such evidence, you want to present it to the court immediately. Present the evidence indicating that Sir Belduke's death could have been suicide.
It was a suicide letter.
Take that!
That's Sir Belduke's letter. Let's see. It was addressed to the storyteller, wasn't it?
This is the last letter written by Sir Belduke. Now, if his death was suicide, then this letter may well be his suicide note.
Objection!
What we have here is nothing more than a blank sheets of parchment! Whether or not there was a suicide note is something we can only speculate about.
That's right. But there is one person who knows whether this letter was really a suicide note.
You mean the person who swapped its contents? In other words, you, Jean Greyerl. Witness, you stole Sir Belduke's letter on the night of the crime. Tell us, what was written in it?
I don't know.
What? You don't know?
I did steal the letter, yes. But I don't know what its contents were.
You mean you have not read it?
I couldn't bring myself to read it. It seemed that if I did, everything that had happened since Master Belduke saved my life would be ruined in an instant. I've taken it out and held it in my hands many times, but no matter what, I just couldn't. Miss Greyerl,
can you tell us where that letter is now? Please don't tell me you burned it. Please don't tell me you burned it. Please don't say you burned it.
I have it here.
You had it on your person the entire time? Holy freaking crap! Oh! You're carrying it around with you? If you were searched, you would have been done for!
That night...
At least Phoenix can point that out.
Having killed Master Belduke, I decided to stay in his residence. I knew my identity would be revealed sooner or later, and I was ready for it. So, until that time, I decided to keep this letter with me. Milord.
Yes, witness?
If you don't mind, could you please read it aloud? Now that I'm here, in this place of judgment, I think I'm finally ready to hear what Master wrote.
Humph.
Hold it!
Miss Greyerl, I think you should be the one to read it.
Me?
Sir Belduke wrote this letter to the storyteller as he was preparing to die. I think it's only right his last words should be read by you.
Yes, you're right. I see. I understand. Please allow me to read the letter aloud. My dear friend, I hope you will be able to forgive me for leaving this world of my own will. I have finally made this decision. Having seen that accursed Belltower
appear in the flames on that dreadful night, that lightning was a sign that we have angered the gods. What I have done cannot be forgiven. I can never escape from it. For the past few days, I have been thinking that it might be best to simply expose everything. This town's secret. The truth about the witch. Of course, I understand that secrets need to be kept. However, I have grown very tired. I'm afraid I cannot keep the secret any longer. I have only two concerns. The first is my daughter. It pains me to be leaving her alone in this world, although she probably doesn't think of me as her father.
A daughter?
Wait a minute.
I was not aware that Sir Belduke had a daughter.
Wait a minute.
Mr. Belduke seemed to know a lot about this town. This town's sacred, and the truth about the witch.
Truth about the witch? Somehow, I don't think he was talking about Miss Grayer.
Oh. The second matter, weighing heavily on my mind, is that Jean will be left on her own.
Seeing her growing up, so strong and righteous, in defiance of her fate, had given me hope. A short while ago, she brought me my usual, and what will be my last, drink. There are so many things I wanted to tell her, but I could only manage a thank you. She is a very sharp child. Had I said any more, she would have caught on. You could call me a selfish man, but I didn't wish my last memory of her to be a sad one.
Master Belduke. If the fate handed to her by this town has made her life an ordeal until now, I hope from the bottom of my heart that a wonderful story awaits her next. I intend to leave my residence to her. And I would like you to look out for her.
Alas, it is time for me to put my pen down. My dear friend, what I truly wish to express to you is too complicated for words. I hope one day you will understand, but for now I bid you farewell. The time has come for me to go.
This letter, it wasn't a denunciation of me being a witch.
Master Belduke cared about you until the very end.
Yes, how could I have forgotten? I'm sure I knew it all along. So why did I? How could I have done that to him?
Miss Grayer.
Milord. What is it, Inquisitor Barnum? I think it is about time for the guilty verdict.
Guilty?
The Inquisition withdraws the charges against Maya Fey and charges Jean Greyjoy with being a witch. All the evidence corroborates with this accusation, and she even admits her guilt. Hence, the Inquisition asks the witch be found guilty and punished immediately.
Objection!
Not so fast, Inquisitor Barnum. What do you want now, Sir Blue Knight?
Admittedly, Miss Grayer did attempt to strangle Sir Belduke, but he had consumed a deadly poison and was already dead at the time. Therefore, she is not guilty of murder. And she never was guilty of murder, except for a goat, but she did that on accident and tried to kill herself for doing that and started a new life, and ever since has not tried to do anything bad or anything and try to leave her witchly ways. And so, seriously. And one more thing. It also wasn't Miss Grayer who turned Professor Layton into gold. There was another witch present at the crime scene. The defendant Maya saw hers too. To put it simply, Miss Grayer didn't kill anyone.
Yeah, She didn't kill anyone, and yet you still want to burn her?
Maya!
Do you even know how it feels to be put in this cage? It's like everyone's against you, and it's super frightening. I'm not a witch, but I've been thrown into this cage and almost sentenced to something I didn't do. And now you're about to do the same to another person? That's just not right!
Is that all you have to say?
Huh?
The one who's in the wrong is not me, but you, Sir Blue Knight.
What?
Whether the witch committed a crime or not is completely irrelevant. This is the witch's court. All witches must be punished by fire.
But that's crazy!
Why? Why, Barnum? Inquisitor Barnum is absolutely right. Being a witch is a crime. You understand that, don't you, Miss Gray Earl?
Yes.
Very well then. The court is ready to issue the final verdict. Maya Faye is found innocent, and in her place, Jean Grey Earl is found guilty of being a witch and shall be cast into the fire.
No, you can't! Hold it! Please, hold the verdict!
Espella? What is it now, Espella Cantabella?
There is nothing else we can do. This is the course of things, and you should know it well.
Indeed. All witches shall be cast into the flames. That is the law of this town. A law that was written by your very own father. And furthermore, a law that has always been obeyed in the town of Labyrinthia.
A town like this should never exist in the first place.
What? Such insolence!
That's heresy! She's criticizing the storyteller's story! Even the storyteller's daughter has no right to criticize the story!
Do you even listen to yourself?
Trials in which innocent people are sentenced to death by fire. I should make sure this is the last one.
What do you mean, Espella?
Since you're also keen on the rules created by the storyteller, you should know exactly what I mean.
Talking about burning the Great Witch and making all witches not be witches anymore.
The stipulation for ending the witch trials. Once the Great Witch Bazella is burned, the witch trials will end. At present, I am under suspicion. You know very well why that is, don't you?
You? You don't mean that you're,
I am guilty.
No.
I am the Great Witch Bazella.
No!
What?
Now, cast me into the flames and let Miss Grail free. Miss Canterbell! This shall be the last of the witch trials. No one else need be burned hereafter.
Espella, just... what are you saying? I can't let you do that!
Please, Mr. Wright, let me do as I wish.
And if you're not... and if you're just trying to cast yourself into fire and you're not the Great Witch, she'll just be found as a witch later when another witch comes, and you're just prolonging the inevitable until we find the actual Great Witch.
Concerning the people of Labyrinthia.
No! Please don't do it! There must be another way! You don't need to do this!
It's all right. Luke, Maya, Mr. Wright, and Mr. Layton. I truly appreciate all you have done for me.
This can't be happening.
Miss Cantabella, your confession will have very serious, or rather, fatal consequences for you. May we assume that you fully understand those consequences and are willing to accept them?
I am Aspella Cantabella, the storyteller's daughter. But I also have another name. I am the Great Witch Bazella. I have lived hidden in the dark pages of my father's story, deceiving all of you. Many lives have been sacrificed because of me. But that shall end today.
Court attendants, seize that woman! She is the Great Witch, Bazella.
Aspella.